Hi everyone, it's Jacque again from the aquarium, and I'm down here at the Harding Road Rocky Shore. Now we're really lucky here in Hawke's Bay to have a resource such as this accessible by everyone. And this is also one of our very popular education programs that we do with school groups. And I know that myself and the rest of the team are really excited for when we are able to get the groups back down here and investigating some of the very cool animals that live down here at the Rocky Shore. Now, it's always best to come down to the Rocky Shore at low tide. Now, we recommend that you can do this within about a 3-hour period, 2 hours before low tide through to about an hour afterwards. Yeah. These rocks can be sharp, so I'd recommend that you wear an old pair of shoes that you don't mind getting wet, just like I'm wearing today. Now, it's always very important to keep one eye on the ocean at all times, because you never know when those rogue waves might come in and get you just a little bit wet. The other thing, of course, are the rocks. Now, we have to be very careful moving around these rocks, because they do move. They can be slippery because there are very small pieces of algae growing on them. Now we can touch pretty much any animal that lives down here at the Rocky Shore, and there is an important thing that we need to remember, and that is to wet our hands. Now of course, wet hands mean that they're nice and cold, means that we don't hurt the animals. If we keep our hands dry, then they're very hot and we can easily burn the animals. Now these animals are going to live under the rocks, on top of the rocks, around the rocks, in the water, you name it. So whenever we move a rock to look underneath it, just make sure we do pick it up and move it over very gently. Once we've finished looking under that rock, it is vitally important that we remember to return it the same way that we found it. Keep in mind, these are their homes, and we want to make sure that their homes are returned the same way as when we arrived. Now, if you sit quietly enough at the edge of a rock pool, it's amazing how it will come to life. Starfish will start moving, you might see little glass shrimps and fish, and the hermit crabs will all start interacting with each other. The most popular snails you'll see here are these two. Most people will call them cat's eyes or boo-boos. They are in fact two different animals. The one on the left is the cat's eye, and on the right is the dark top shell. The easiest way to tell them apart is that the cat's eye is greener. It quite often has barnacles growing on it, and the small trapdoor on the underside is greeny, it's white, and it's lumpy. The dark top shell has spiral lines on it, and on the underside it has small white dots and a very smooth little trapdoor. Another snail you will see is the whelk. This is kind of the shape of a rugby ball, and this animal is in fact a carnivore. It has a small black spike that comes out, and it'll help flick off the other animal off the rock, and then the whelk can easily eat the meat inside. Yummy. The most commonly seen starfish down here is the cushion star. They usually have 5 arms, although we sometimes see them with 4 or 6 arms. If you ever pick up a starfish and you see a whitish jelly on the underside, that is, in fact, their stomach. Starfish are carnivores, but they have no teeth, so the way that they feed is amazing, if not disgusting to think about. They'll crawl on top of the animals that they want to eat, quite often a crab for example. Their stomach will come up out of their mouth. They'll start digesting the fish or the crab until it's a lovely crabby soup, and then they'll suck it all back in. Yummy! You might also see the 7, 9 or 11 armed starfish. These are chitons. You'll often see the green chiton, the snakeskin chiton, and if you're lucky, you may even see a hairy chiton. Then there are the crazy looking animals. This is the duck-billed limpet. They kind of look like a parwa without the shell. Now if you gently stroke its back, you'll see a small shell appear. This shell is the shape of a duck's beak, hence the name, the duck's bill limpet. Talking about parwa, do you know how they get their colours? It's actually from the algae that they eat. So if they had more pink on the inside, they're eating more red seaweed. If they have more of the greeny blue colour on the inside, they're eating the green seaweed. Now this incredible animal is the sea hare, and they are related to sea slugs. Now as you can see, they can be handled gently. Also, depending on the time of the year, you might even get to see an octopus or two. Now did you know that they have 9 brains and 3 hearts?
There we go, lots of little crabbies. And this little guy here, where my finger is now, is a sea anemone.
Well everyone, I hope you enjoyed our little adventure down here at the Harding Road Rocky Shore. We saw some amazing animals, there's no doubt about that. Now just remember, when you do come down here, stay safe, look after yourselves, and look after the animals down here as well. Remember, this is their home, we're visitors to them. So just enjoy yourself, keep your hands nice and wet, watch where you stand, and make sure you put the rocks back exactly how you find them. It's really important. Have fun everyone, and we'll see you another day. Kikite!